Sam here from Creative Minds. In this week's video, we're going to talk about a couple of features that are available with the Pro Plus and the e-commerce editions of the CM Tooltip Glossary. These include embedding audio and video in your tooltip, as well as the Doubleclick feature, and Merriam-Webster, Amazon, and Wikipedia support. Let's get started.
This is what it's going to look like when you embed a video in that tooltip. When you hover over a term, this little YouTube or video player will appear, and you can go ahead and play that video right in the tooltip. Getting this video feature to appear in the tooltip is very easy. What you're going to do is create a new glossary item, and then you're going to get this glossary item page where you put the term in this content box at the top. And then you're going to need to make some changes in the CM Tooltip term properties. You're going to absolutely want to check off Disable Tooltip Background for this term because this allows the video to appear in the tooltip by making that tooltip transparent. And then you can also disable Featured Image, Amazon Widget, Wikipedia, Merriam-Webster, Google, etc., so that the only thing that appears in the tooltip is that video. And then putting that video embed code in is the key to getting this video to appear. So down at the bottom on the right, you're going to put in your embed code for the video, which you can get from YouTube or Vimeo. And you can also change the parameters inside the embed code. So once you've done all that, you can publish or update that glossary item. And then you can check out what it's going to look like. Again, when you hover over, you'll be able to play that video right inside of the tooltip. Embedding audio in your tooltip allows this audio player to appear when you hover over a term. You can then play the audio file within the tooltip. Setting this up is very similar to setting up any other glossary item or a video glossary item. You're going to put the term in the content box at the top. You'll also leave this content area blank. And then you're going to go down to the box that says CM Tooltip Audio. Here you're going to need to put an audio URL to that audio file. One way you can do this is through uploading that audio file to your media library. When you upload an audio file to your media library and you go to that file, you will find a file URL over here on the side. So you can just use that URL, and you're also going to change some of the term properties. Like for the video embed, you're also going to want to absolutely check this disable tooltip background for this term. And then you can also go ahead and disable these other properties so that the only thing that appears when you hover over that term is the audio file. So another thing to keep in mind with the embed audio feature is that that audio file will also turn up on the actual term page, and you can play that file inside of the term page. One setting you can adjust with the audio embed is how that audio player appears when you hover over that term. So inside of your tooltip settings, if you go to e-commerce settings, and then audio player settings, when you check this audio player limited box, what's going to happen is that when you hover over that term, that audio player will just be a play sign. Double click is when someone clicks twice on any word on a particular page. And when you have this feature enabled, you can choose from a variety of services that are actually going to appear in that tooltip. So for example, here we have Wikipedia support. So in order to use the Doubleclick feature, which is available with the e-commerce edition of the tooltip, what you're going to need to do is go into your CM Tooltip Glossary settings, go to your e-commerce settings, and then you're going to scroll down to Doubleclick settings and enable that Doubleclick. And then you can choose which Doubleclick service you want to use. Right now we have Wikipedia, but you could also have an Amazon Doubleclick service, for example. When you select Amazon support for your DoubleClick feature, when someone double-clicks on, for example, iPhone, in the tooltip, an Amazon box with different products related to the iPhone will appear. In order to use Amazon support for DoubleClick, you'll need to input your Amazon API in the e-commerce settings. Here you can also choose which Amazon domain you want to use, and you can also control the widget size and which product category that Amazon support is going to come from. Likewise, if you were to select Merriam-Webster for your DoubleClick service, when someone double-clicks on a particular word on your page, for example, product, this Merriam-Webster online dictionary support will appear inside of the tooltip. One thing to keep in mind is that you're going to need to input your API key here on your settings page. So next, let's talk about shortcodes. You can find the tooltip shortcodes on your settings page. Here where it says supported shortcodes, you're going to show these. And the ones we're going to talk about today are the Merriam-Webster Dictionary and Thesaurus shortcodes, and also the Wikipedia shortcode. So what these let you do, they let you get the Wikipedia support and the Merriam-Webster support directly in a term page or a post. So what you're going to do is take this shortcode, and then you're going to go into your post or term page, and then you're just going to input that shortcode. For example, this is for the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. So you just put that term name in there. And again, this is the Wikipedia one at the bottom, and we're going to put in the term dog. So then when you view this post, you can see that you get the Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary support directly inside of the post, as well as the Wikipedia support. You are going to need an API key for the Merriam-Webster Dictionary and Thesaurus, and you can get this by registering your account on this website. And the great thing about this is that if you have a relatively low traffic site and you only have less than 1,000 queries using that API key per day, it's actually free of charge. The last feature we're going to talk about today, which comes with the Pro Plus and the e-commerce editions of the tooltip, is glossary categories. So on your glossary term page, you're going to go down to the categories box, and here you can associate each term with one or more categories. So let's show you how to create these categories. On your dashboard, you're going to go to your tooltip, go to categories, and here you can add new categories. You're going to put in the name, and then go ahead and add that category. And these are the categories that appear here when you edit a term. Also in your glossary settings, you'll see supported shortcodes. If you show these, what we're interested in here is the glossary category index. You're just going to copy this, and when you want an index to appear on a certain page, you're going to go ahead and put that glossary index code here. And then you're just going to define which category you want that index to show. So once you've put in that shortcode, this is what the index looks like. And as you can see, you can search this glossary category. You can also search all or alphabetically. And as you can see, there's also a list of all of the terms that I've associated with category one.
Visit tooltip.cminds.com to explore and purchase the Tooltip Glossary plugin. Also be sure to check out and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/cminds channel.